Hello guys and good day. And this is our part 2 lecture of our module 3, which is entitled Intermolecular Forces. Last meeting, we talked about the families of organic compounds or functional groups contained in the organic molecules. Now we are now discussing what type of intermolecular forces that they're exhibiting when they tend to interact to one another, which is a intermolecular forces. Now, intermolecular forces is both applicable to organic and inorganic compounds. But since our subject is organic chemistry, the scope of our intermolecular forces of attraction discussion will only cover the organic compound aspect of our discussion. So in this lecture, we will talk about the relationship of physical properties such as boiling points and molecular structure of the organic compounds and the intermolecular forces of attraction present in our organic compounds, which are the dipole-dipole, hydrogen bonds, and dispersion forces. So this slide contains only 24, okay? And wala kayong naiintindihan sa ating discussion, guys, you may feel free, guys, to PM me kung ano bang inquiries ninyo, and feel free to come back. So let's start our discussion proper. Okay, intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces is defined as hindi siya na-include dito, is the interaction between molecules from the word intermolecular. So it is an interaction between molecules. Since sa may kuha natin, a typical example of this is water. Contains a millions, trillions, and billions of molecules in only contains in a glass. So what does the interaction, kung ano ba nagaganap doon? Okay. First and foremost is we have the ionic compounds. Meron palang ionic compounds dun sa ating mga organic substance. Kapag nagkaroon na siya ng charge, but it's not usually ionic compounds, but rather organic compounds. So ionic compounds, to be in general, it is the cationic and anionic interaction of our inorganic compounds, which may be present in water when sodium chloride is dissolved in water. And okay, this one here, our ionic compounds is a well-ordered crystalline state at solid state and more random at liquid state kapag sila yung na-melt. Okay, the substance, ang didiscuss ang kwento nitong summarize lang nito or at the point of this PowerPoint is masyadong malakas yung energy ng ating ionic compounds para ma-break mo yung bonds nila. Diba, sa may experiment ninyo, sa may sodium chloride, yung sodium chloride natin doon is hinit na natin at high temperature, hindi pa rin siya natutunaw. Pero yung sugar natin is nag-start na siya mag-decompose and later on, siya ay magiging uling. So the point of this is our ionic compounds required large amount of thermal energy to require to break up the orderly structure of its crystal. Since our ionic compounds are crystals that contains positive and negative ions in an orderly crystalline structure. Okay, so the boiling points of ionic compounds are higher still compared to the ionic organic compounds decomposed before they boil. The ionic organic compounds that tackled here is the charged ionic compounds that you will later on, we will discuss in this subject, of course, na encounter nyo rin sa mga ating resonance structure na kung saan yung oxygen natin ay nagiging negatively charged. And yung ating ammonium ion is positively charged. That's the ionic organic compounds. Now, these are the selected physical properties of some organic compounds here. So, we have ethene, chloroethene, ethyl alcohol, acetaldehyde, acetic acid, and sodium acetate. And these are their melting points and boiling points and their condensed structure. Lahat sila ay organic compounds, guys. Pero bakit kaya ganun? Bakit different sila ng melting point and boiling point? Ano ang nagdi-distinguish ng characteristics sa kanila? Bakit ganun? Consider natin yung water and yung ating ethanol, di ba? They are both liquid. Okay, they're both liquid. States of matter, they're both liquid. Miscible pa sila. Pero the question here, guys, is bakit sila nagbo-boil at different temperature samantalang pares lang naman silang liquid states in the liquid states. Pares sila. So they're supposed to boil at same temperature since they're liquid, but they're not. So anong phenomena ang nangyayari doon? Doon, guys, papasok ang ating intermolecular forces of attraction or van der Waals forces. Okay, ito ay nag-occur. Okay, ulitin ko ulit. Ito ay mangyayari. Ang scope natin dito, guys, is only covered to be organic compounds. Organic compounds lang tayo, guys, ha? Hindi tayo pupunta ng inorganic. Ang inorganic lang na matapain natin ito, guys, is water, which naapalog siya doon sa may hydrogen bonding natin. Okay? Now, there are three types of intermolecular forces in organic compounds. We have a dipole-dipole, hydrogen bonding, and dispersion forces. These are the forces that act between the molecules. Now, let's start with the dipole-dipole. Okay, dipole-dipole have a permanent dipole moments resulting from a non-uniform distribution of bonding electrons. Usually contains a bonded heteroatom in an aliphatic hydrocarbon. So when you say a dipole-dipole, as discussed, kung makatanda niyo pa siya, guys, is meron daw siyang dipole moments. Or let's say sa ating example na acetaldehyde dito is, i-drawing ko na lang din ulit, sa acetaldehyde natin is, di ba, we have CH3 and C double bond O and CH3 here. Ang mangyari dito is, di ba, oxygen is more electronegative than carbon. So therefore, ang electronegatives natin ay papunta dito. The dipole moments will be here. And this will yield a partially negatively charged and partially positively charged. So meron siyang permanent dipole. Meron siyang dipole moment. And what about yung nandito? Ang tawag dito sa mga nandito is, ang nag-occurs dito, guys, is dispersion forces na matataan natin mamaya sa third type ng ating intermolecular forces of attraction natin. So meron siyang permanent dipole. Now, when another, kung natin here, when another, let's say, acetate, okay, ito, ano ang pangalan ng compound natin? Acetaldehyde, tama ba? Acetone, this is an acetone, sorry, nakalimbat ko na. Okay, here, the partially positive will interact to the partially positive, our magnet interaction. So, ganyan ang mangyayari sa anila, the oxygen will interact to the carbon since it's partially positive, and so and so and so and so forth. So, ito yung intermolecular forces of attraction na nangyayari between dun sa ating pan natin, sa ating acetone. And kung titignan nyo yung electrostatic map nyo, guys, is the red area, the red region here shows, depicts a more electronegative region na nag-attract, while the blue is depicts less electronegative region or partially positively charged. And then the partially positively charged will interact with the partially negative, and so forth hanggang sa walang katapusan. Ayan. Okay? Understood? Now, punta na tayo. Okay, these are the common interaction between the atoms, the examples. Ito yung acetone, dipole-dipole attraction, and these are, what's this? A chloromethane, partially negative kasi meron siyang permanent dipole, meron siyang dipole moment, di ba? Okay, ano ba yun? Sintoy ko dito. Diba? We have here C, and then H here, and then H, and then H dito, and then Cl. Now, we all know that the hydrogen is less electronegative than carbon. So therefore, yung carbon natin is, lahat ng pandito is papunta saan niya. It will attract the electrons of hydrogen towards the carbon. But, we have a heteroatom, as we discussed earlier, that the yung kwan natin yung itong electrons sa mani carbon ay mapupunta lahat kay chlorine. Na kung saan yung electrons ni hydrogen ay ma-attract na lahat kay chlorine. So therefore, ang magiging result niyan is we have a dipole moment at this area. And so therefore, this will be the partially negative charge and partially positive charge that will create a dipole moment and magkaroon siya ng interaction between its molecules hanggang sa walang hanggan. So, ayan yun. Okay, next is our hydrogen bonding. A very strong dipole-dipole attraction. Okay. Strong, it is a type of dipole-dipole interaction. A strong dipole-dipole attraction pala, sorry. Between hydrogen atoms. Strongly bonded to electronegative atoms such as oxygen, nitrogen, and fluorine. Stronger than dipole-dipole intermolecular forces. So, it is a hydrogen bonding. Ganitong common example niya is the backbone of our DNA here. Consider this thymine and adenine. Kapag daw yung H natin ay naipagband sa O, which is O, isa siya sa may most electronegative atoms natin, ang tawag dyan is hydrogen bonding. Now, dito naman, wala pa tayong example dito. Dito, ayan, hydrogen bonding ang tawag doon. Once the H interacted with the O and F, that's automatically a hydrogen bonding. Okay? Ayan, OH, and also the NH and OH. Ang common example nito, guys, is water and ammonia. They are hydrogen bonding. Nag-exhibit sila ng hydrogen bonding because the O is bonded to H. And the our ammonia, N, bonded to H. So therefore, hydrogen bonding. Sir, yun din naman pong ana, ito rin naman pong CH3 na to, ah, itong region po na to, sir. Ah. Meron din naman pong hydrogen bonding dito sa may carb, sa may kwana. Yung hydrogen, nakabond din naman po sa may carbon. Ah. Bakit hindi po siya hydrogen bonding? Okay, huwag kang galit. Okay, kaya ganun guys, kasi nga, sinabi ko kanina, is dapat yung hydrogen natin is bonded to the most electronegative atom. Diba? To the most electronegative atoms such as O and F. So, ganun ang mangyayari. Okay, i-cluttered up ko lang yung pa natin dito. Is kasi nga itong C natin, and H here, ito yung C, CL, mag-interact siya dito sa H and pwede rin dito sa may O. So, mga ganung bagay. It's not hydrogen bonding since it does not interact with C and it does not interact with the O and F. So, mga ganung bagay. Okay. And so and so forth. So, ibig sabihin, kapag kumuha ng tubig, ano ba tubig dito? Okay, wait lang. Hindi, huwag ka na ulit. Okay, yung tubig dito, kapag tinalagay siyang ganun, so it is a hydrogen bonding na nag-exhibit ng intermolecular forces nila. So, hydrogen bonding, kaya pala malakas yung bond. Kaya pala nanatiling liquid. Oo, nanatiling liquid. Kasi kung maka-encounter kayo sa may laboratory, guys, yung ibang liquid kasi nabe-vaporize agad due to the weaker intermolecular forces that say they exhibited. Kaya sila nagiging pan. Mataas yung anilang vapor pressure, di ba? Nasa may lab report number one yan. Sinagotan niya yan since they are volatile organic compounds. Obviously. Then our third type, which is the weakest, is our dispersion forces. Okay. Ang ganito lang clue dito, dispersion forces affects by two factors, which are the relative porosity of an atom, and second is the relative surface area of the molecules involved. Larger surface area is equal to weaker intermolecular forces of dispersion force, and longer molecules exhibits a stronger intermolecular forces here. Now, ang common example nito guys is, okay, or ito yung distortion ng ating electron clouds. This distortion our electron clouds. Now, consider natin ang ating kwan dito. Okay, huwag na natin tanggalin yan. Consider natin yung ating kwan. Ating methane. Or yeah, it is a methane. Now, alam naman natin, guys, that the carbon is the most electronegative atoms in the methane. So, therefore, the electrons are towards here. Now, sa ating physics, di ba, lahat sila ay pahatak dito. Is there any resultant force? No, there's no resultant force. So, therefore, there will be no dipole moment. Bakit dito, sir, may dipole moment? Kasi nga, di ba, the H, papunta kay carbon, lahat sila. And then, yung CL is hinahatak lahat. So, there is a resultant force. So, dipole moment, hindi ko siya na-discuss, is greater than zero. So, therefore, kaya nga siya ay naging dipole-dipole. And dito, wala. So, ibig sabihin, lahat sila ay partially positively charged. Partially positively charged. Nandito dito sa loob yung negative. So, surroundings niya is all partially positive. Wala man lang partially negative as compared dun sa may electrostatic map natin sa ating acetone molecule. Now, once kasi ito, kung mapapansin niyo, once itong molecule na ito here guys is na-distort, it will create a dispersion forces na kung saan magkakaroon ng partially positive and partially negative. Na kung saan yan ay distorted. Hindi natin alam kung nasaan yung partially negative and partially positive. So ganito yung magiging interaction nila. Magkakaroon lang ng distortion of partially positive and partially negative charge for the sake of interaction between its molecules around them at the same of methane. So ganun yung mangyari doon. And consider this iodine, napapaligiran siya ng partially positive. And this one here is partially positive. So, ganyan. So, another, dito ngayon papasok yung concept na surface area. Surface area natin. Okay. Ito ay, for example, here, the surface area, this one here has a strong dispersion forces. Bakit? Kasi mas malaki yung surface area nito. Eh sir, parehas lang naman pong molecule itong dalawang ito. Ah. But ito mas malaki sa iodine. Kasi nga, dito makakapit ngayon yung ating atomic radius. Our atomic radius na diniscuss sa inyong general chemistry. Iodine has a greater atomic radius than the fluorine. So therefore, mas mataas yung electron clouds niya. Na kung saan meron tayong dispersion forces here, then mag-distort, mag-interact sila, lower surface, higher surface area here, as discussed here, di ba, larger surface area. Ay, hindi, sa onto. Sa, di-discuss ko ito mamaya, sa onto, sa organic pala. Dini-discuss ko dito is about inorganic. Kahit ganun. Okay, sige. Okay, ayan. Dito is ito, makuha siya. So, another here. And although organic sila, pero mamaya, i-discuss ko dito. Sa part na alam, aliphatic hydrocarbons. But the point here, this dito is the point of attachment pala. The point of attachment of the molecules. Sorry guys. So disregard niyo yung surface area muna, but focus on the point of attachment of the molecules. Here, so mas maraming interaction, stronger dispersion forces. And here, it is a weaker dispersion forces kasi kaunti lang point of attraction. Now dito, pupunta ngayon is dito sa ating molecule. Here. Ito yung tinutukoy ko ngayon na dali lang ah. Weaker IMF, larger surface area. Okay, weaker IMF here. Sige, mamaya ako na babaguhin yan. Okay, sige. Okay, dito na ngayon papasok ang ating pentene. Pentene. Now, we all know pentene. Kung isa-search niyan sa internet, they are both, ang formula na is C5H12. Now, we have this isomer here na kung saan more branching. More branching siya. So, dapat palit ako yung concepts kanina. Okay, more branching concepts. Here, dito, mas malaki yung surface area. So, therefore, okay, napag-conclude ko na stronger IMF. So, sorry guys. This one here is stronger IMF. Larger surface area. And dito, idadagdag ko lang guys. Sorry kung medyo magulo. Since this is raw footage. Okay, edit ko muna. Sorry for that convenience. More branching carbons. Dito papasok yung weaker IMF. Weaker IMF. Okay. So, ayan. Now, consider this, again, kung mapapansin ninyo, this one has a larger surface area. So, there are greater point of attachment. Pero dito, smaller surface area lang siya. Kasi more yung branching. Kukunti yung point of attachment. So therefore, this one here has a greater dispersion forces than this here. So naka-apekto rin pala yung factors ng isomerism sa may intermolecular forces ng ating organic compounds. So ganito yan. Dito ngayon papasok ang ating boiling points. A boiling point of a liquid is defined by the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the liquids equals to the vapor pressure of the atmospheric pressure above it. So equal yung vapor pressure, yung pressure ng liquid and the atmospheric pressure of the atmosphere. So ganun, it is pressure dependent. Okay, consider this one here. This is just a typical example. 180 mm equals to 760 torricelli and is equals to 760 millimeter mercury na kung saan tinail nyo yan sa inyong gas law in organic compounds. So dito naman, okay, so therefore, kung isa-summarize natin, this is the strengthened of our IMF. Which dispersion is the weakest, dipole-dipole, stronger than the dispersion forces, and the strongest intermolecular forces is the hydrogen bonding. Now, consider this example here. Okay, consider this example here. Okay, strengthened of the IMF. Now, dito, i-arrange na daw siya in terms of increasing boiling point. Saan yung mas malaking boiling point dyan? Okay. Saan kaya? Okay, which one here, kung i-arrange natin sila, although may sagot na, paano natin malalaman yan? Okay, first and foremost, guys, increasing boiling point down. Itong diethyl ether natin, ano kaya siya? What type of intermolecular forces ang in-exhibit? This one here, guys, diba? Hetero atoms aliphatic. This one is dipole. Dipole. Next. Second, ano to? Dipole-dipole dispersion or hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bonding kasi the H is bonded to O. So this one here is H bonding. And next here is what? Straight chain. So therefore, this one is dispersion forces. Okay. Now we all know this one is the weakest. This one is the pang second. And this one is pangalawa. So therefore, increasing boiling point will be pentane, the 3. And then this one is the 2 and 1. So, increasing pala, no? Okay, increasing. So, balik ta rin natin. Okay, increasing, syempre, mauna yung pentane. Mauna yung pentane, weakest. As a greater boiling point, next is the diethyl ether. Ayun, although nakasulat naman na, sinusulat ko lang. And then next here is the sec butyl alcohol. So, ganun lang siya. In terms of boiling points here, so therefore, nasagot na yung question natin kanina na kung bakit yung ethanol and water natin boils at different temperature. Kasi nga, ganun, they're exhibiting a intermolecular forces. Okay, explain natin. Yung ethanol natin has a structure of this, while water has this. Okay, both are exhibiting OH bonding. Tama. Pero bakit yung water natin is 100 degrees Celsius and yung ethanol natin is, search natin sa Google. Search natin sa Google. Okay. Search natin sa Google is boiling point of ethanol is only 78.37 degrees Celsius. Bakit kaya ganun? Parehas lang naman silang may kwan. Parehas silang hydrogen bonding. Guys, take note, di ba? Pag sinunod nyo yung structure niya, meron tayong, anong tawag sa forces na yon? Dispersion forces. We have a dispersion forces here at the ethanol. Ito, actually, dalawa sila, di ba? Kaya nawi-weakens yung intermolecular forces of attraction ng ating ethanol. Kaya mas mababa yung boiling point. Unlike water, there are two hydrogen bonds exhibiting, kaya mataas yung boiling point. So that answers the question kung bakit ganun na mas mataas yung boiling point ng water natin kaysa doon sa ethanol nung nagkaroon tayo ng virtual experiment sa ating distillation. Okay? Okay. Okay. Okay, next is here. Ito naman. This will be, mahaba pa pala. Okay. This one here will be your assignment. And again, huwag ninyo siyang sasagutan hanggat hindi ko siya pinupost. It's your learning activity. So, wait lang kayo. And kayang ayan yan, sagutin naman. Madali lang naman yan. Identify the intermolecular process involved. Okay. Dispersion, dipole, and hydrogen bonding. And then, since ito, parehas may dispersion, titignan ninyo yung surface area. So, kayo na bahala dyan. Parang sinabi ko na rin yung sagot, di ba? And so, this will be a bonus point. Pero, sasagutan nyo pa rin for the sake of your learning. Para mas matutunan nyo. And then, okay. Ngayon, ang isang application ng intermolecular forces is the solubility. We all know this, guys. Ito lang yung principles niya, but the general rule of thumb here is like dissolves light. And ito, so ayun, di ba? So kaya sila miscible, consider this. So another here is solubility and miscibility. So bakit miscible ang methanol sa ating water? Kasi nga, they are both contains hydrogen bonding. Kaya sila miscible. And also that answers the question sa ating, dito sa ating kwan, kung bakit, kung tinanong ko kanina, na miscible yung ethanol sa water, kasi nga, they are both containing hydrogen bonding. Pero kapag mas tumataas na yung hydrophobic character, pero mamaya ikaw, ano natin yan. Okay? Now, dito na ngayon papasok. Another one here is, di ba, pinag-usapan natin yung miscibility. Dito ulit, may isang consideration. Hindi lahat ng hydrogen bonding ay maghahalo-halo. We have this term na hydrophobic and hydrophilic. Hydrophobic means incompatible with water. Hydrophilic means compatible with water. When you say hydro, ito ba? Ito. Ito bang molecule na ito? Is it soluble pa ba sa water? The answer is not. Kasi mas dominant, guys, yung ating hydrophobic portion. Ano ba hydrophobic portion natin? Itong dispersion forces natin dito. So kapag mas dominant siya, guys, hindi na siya miscible sa ating water. So I think yung butanol is slightly soluble pa. So mga ganun-ganun bagay. Pero yung ang soluble lang, most soluble lang sa water is methanol na alcohol, aliphatic alcohol, okay? Methanol, ethanol, and propanol. So ganyan. And typical detergent molecule. So ganyan, okay? These are the general rules, guidelines for water solubility. 3 grams of organic compounds dissolved in 100 ml of water, and 1 to 3 carbons are water soluble alcohol. 45 carbons are borderline, so slightly soluble na sila. And 6 carbon atoms are insoluble na. So therefore, yung pag yung carbon atoms natin contains 4 to 5, such as butanol and pentanol, slightly soluble. And kapag hexanol na, hindi na siya insoluble na siya sa water. So these are the summary of electric forces of water, ng ating intermolecular forces or attractive forces. So ayan. Is there any questions, qualification so far? Okay, so wala naman. Okay. And that will be at the end of our lecture part 2 of our module 3, guys. So thank you for listening, guys. And if you have any further questions, just mag-chat na sa DC and pipilit ako siya sa mga. So again, thank you guys for listening and have a good night.